Hey guys, it's Cameron here with Emerson House Buyers. Every week I bring you tools, tactics, strategies, lessons I've learned, things that helped me build up a sizable portfolio in about 2 years. I got a question from a friend, and I don't know how applicable this is to the audience, but I feel like there are some people I know who are self-employed, who work maybe a 1099 job, or work for themselves, start their own business. I know a handful of people like that. Not many, but a handful. And the question was, how do I buy a house if I'm self-employed? How do I buy a house if I'm self-employed? Do you guys have any ideas? What's immediately running through your brain? Yeah. We have three things that I could think of, guys, that have helped me. Doesn't matter how much income I was making, these three things you could do to get a loan. One, a massive down payment. So when you guys come to the bank and say, I'm going to buy this $100,000 house, I need a loan, and they're like, no, you don't make any money, it's tough. You can say, well, I'm going to bring $50,000 to the table. They're probably going to say, okay. Maybe, I don't know. But when you guys have a large down payment, if you can scrape together enough cash, banks and people that want to loan you money say, okay, they're invested in it. They think that you're actually going to want to repay it, so they'll be more likely to give you the loan. Doesn't matter if it's a car, whatever it is. If you guys, even if you have bad credit, if you can bring a solid down payment, that really, really makes creditors pay attention. Find a private lender. So guys, this was something that allowed me to grow my my business exponentially because I didn't have to rely on just my money. I could go out and get other people's money, OPM, other people's money, use that to grow the business. So I went out and found some rich guys who didn't want to be in the trenches like I was and wanted to lend me money. And I paid them back. Now, private lenders are not, what's great about them is some of them are more strict than banks, believe it or not, but some of them aren't. And not that that means they're just going to go out on a whim and give you $1 million. But what that means is if they believe in you, if they know that you're hardworking, if they know what you're doing, they're not going to put you in the box that the bank's going to, right? So they're not going to stick you in this little box so you can use other means to maybe get yourself the loan. Sometimes it's more collateral. Sometimes, it's just your personality and they can see that you're working hard. Sometimes it's your job if you're self-employed, sometimes it's your work. They know, well, this guy makes enough, even though maybe he doesn't have it all together now, we'll lend him the money. The third option, guys, and this might seem, maybe you've not thought of this, maybe this just seems too simple, but get a cosigner. I just let a tenant in my property that did not qualify because she brought her dad in as a cosigner. So it was a win-win. Her dad had great credit. She had mediocre credit. He had a great income. She had a mediocre income. Together, as a cosigner, she's fine because he's on the hook for it. So if you have a family member, a friend, somebody with great credit, usually it's going to be family. Somebody with great credit that would lend you the money, that would be willing to put themselves on the loan, meaning that if you don't pay, they have to pay. So make sure that you want to get into that kind of relationship because it is one of those where it can ruin friendships or ruin families or make family dinners very, very, very awkward. Not that I've learned that from experience, thankfully, but I've heard horror stories of basically splitting up families. Those are the three ways, guys. And I just want to emphasize, so private lender could also be a family member or a friend. You know, anybody private that's not a bank. So just want to emphasize that. But again, how do you buy a house if you're self-employed? Huge down payment, private lender, anybody, friend, family, guy with a lot of money, or find somebody who's got a great credit, who's got a good income that can co-sign for you. If that was helpful, let me know. If it wasn't, let me know. I do, like I said, feel for our self-employed folks. You know, it's, I know business is tough. I know that very, very well. So anything I can do to help y'all out, just let me know. I appreciate that. Guys, support small businesses. They're backbone of this country. And like I said, if you enjoyed it, let me know. Let me know if you guys want something else. Do you have any other questions? I'll be happy to answer them. Thanks, guys. See you next week.